Now to a wild chain of events in New Jersey. Police arrest a man accused of leading cops on a pursuit through multiple communities in the middle of the day. It began with a carjacking report near the Atlantic City boardwalk and ended with a stolen car crashing into a house.
NBC 10 Jersey Shore Bureau reporter Ted Greenberg shows us what happened.
Tire tracks, an uprooted tree, and scattered debris. The aftermath of a crash into a Linwood home Saturday afternoon involving a stolen car that police say they'd been pursuing following a carjacking earlier in the day.
Very unusual. This is a very quiet, private neighborhood. So it's very rare that you have any activity of that sort coming through here.
Video from a doorbell camera showing officers ordering the suspect, 59-year-old Kevin Wade, to get out of the Volkswagen, then breaking a window after they say he refused.
It had the potential to put a lot of people at danger.
Police say the ordeal began here on Arkansas Avenue in Atlantic City, just off the boardwalk. According to court records, the suspect forcibly jumped into a woman's car, unsuccessfully tried to lock her inside, then came close to hitting her with the car before driving off. Police nearby heard the woman's screams, then began chasing the car through the city and a number of other nearby communities before they say it got too dangerous for them to keep pursuing it.
From what I'm told, my neighbor was almost hit by the individual in Pleasantville, and when she honked at him, he became enraged and started to follow her.
Darren Maddock is the mayor of Linwood, where another chase began with officers there. Authorities say the suspect soon lost control of the stolen car and crashed. Police ultimately taking the Philadelphia man into custody. They say it's extremely lucky no one was hurt.
Any vehicle pursuit, there's a lot of heightened risk to it, especially on a weekend in the middle of the day where you have increased traffic.
Kevin Wade is now parked at the county jail with a court hearing scheduled for later this week. Ted Greenberg, NBC 10 News.